everyone! I've gotten a lot of feedback recently regarding my recent rotation for Zhezhi in that it wasn't easy to memorize or perform, and have seen several requests for one that's easier to execute. So during my last stream, I cooked with the goal of simplifying the Jinxi Zhezhi rotation, just to see how the DPS changed. Let's look at the results and also the DPS of some other rotations. Disclaimer! The following numbers are based on theoretical rotations that have been tested in combat to ensure their validity. Note that these numbers are not the be-all and end-all for determining strength, as certain teams can be easier or harder to execute, and some may be more consistent while others may be extremely easily interruptible. Take them with a grain of salt. Here's a DPS chart of some various Jinxi teams with different teammates. The DPS shown is the total team DPS over 2 minutes, which includes the opener rotation with as many loop rotations as can fit in the remaining time. 5-star characters are evaluated at S0, with their signature weapon at R1, with 4-star characters at S6. In an ideal scenario, Yinlin is still Jinxi's strongest teammate on paper, though this rotation is fragile and can lose a lot of DPS if you need to dodge. Zhezhi isn't far behind, clocking in at around 54k DPS. The budget comp with Yuanwu, on the other hand, sits at about 41k, but is much easier to play than the other two. This isn't a Jinxi comp, but just for comparison, the Zhezhi main DPS comp with Sanhua performs pretty decently, sitting at 45k. But what about a simplified Zhezhi rotation? In this new rotation, we'll be minimizing swaps, and only going for one Jinxi nuke per rotation. This way, the flow is very simple and easy to remember. Without quick swaps, how effective is this really? It actually comes in at almost 50k DPS, over 90% that of the sweaty rotation, which is pretty surprising. Jinxi, being limited by both stack generation as well as her cooldowns, already has a low optimization ceiling. That is, that improving the rotation past a certain point doesn't yield that much gain. And these numbers show that it's the same deal with Zhezhi. She can be played in an unoptimized rotation to nearly the same potential. In other words, you can turn your brain off! You don't need to try! So what does the rotation actually look like? The TLDR is rush Jinxi's outro in the opener by starting with Jinxi's Echo 1 skill, then do Verena's full concerto combo, going back to Jinxi to do her combo. Then in the loop, simply alternate between Zhezhi and Jinxi's full combo, adding a Verena outro combo on the first loop iteration, and then every other iteration after that. Shown to the right is the main loop. Note that each of Zhezhi and Jinxi's liberation will only be up once every other rotation, so use them when available. And that's all for now. I just wanted to cover both the team comparisons and a simpler rotation, as they were both highly requested. For future guides, I want to make a metric that can accurately give a difficulty score to rotations, but that's still a work in progress. I'll catch you all next time. Bye bye!